got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite, when they're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. I have some news that really excites me. And upsets me at the same time. It excites me because my neighbor, Vermont, has completely nullified the federal hemp ban. I'm going to link you to this article. And what sets Vermont different from other places who have brought forth legislation, they're not waiting for the federal government to say it's okay. And that is outstanding. What upsets me is my native state of New Hampshire, where I dwell now, still has very restrictive laws. Hemp is illegal. The medical marijuana bill is a complete fallacy. You have to be almost dead, and then you can't grow it yourself. You're going to have to buy it from a monopolized market. They're only going to allow four dispensaries in the state. So still, even though the law is passed, it doesn't do anybody any good. But our neighbors are waking up, and I want the entire country to wake up on this. So let's go through some hemp facts. If you want to read the story about Vermont, I'll link you to it. Basically, I want you to know the facts. So let's go through the rundown quickly, shall we? Hemp is among the oldest industries on the planet, going back more than 10,000 years to the beginning of pottery. The Columbia History of the World states that the oldest relic of human industry is a bit of hemp fabric dating back approximately to 8,000 BC. President Washington and Jefferson both grew hemp. Americans were legally bound to grow hemp during the colonial era and the early republic. The federal government subsidized hemp during the Second World War, and U.S. farmers grew about 1 million acres of hemp as part of that program. Hemp seed is nutritious and contains more essential fatty acids than any other source and is second only to soybeans in complete protein, but it is more digestible by humans. Is high in B vitamins and a good source of dietary fiber. Hemp seed is not psychoactive and cannot be used as a drug. There's a link. I'm going to link you to this as well, in case you can't absorb this all at one moment because you've been dumbed down and lied to for so long. The bark of the hemp stalk contains bast fibers, which are among the earth's longest natural soft fibers and are also rich in cellulose. The cellulose and the hemicellulose in the inner woody core, called herds, hemp stalk is not psychoactive. Again, hemp fiber is longer, stronger, more absorbent, and more insulative than cotton fiber. According to the Department of Energy, hemp is a biomass fuel producer, requires the least specialized growing and processing procedures of all hemp products. Do you understand what that means? That means you don't have to put a lot of effort into it, and you don't have to load it down with a bunch of chemicals that end up in the water supply. But we wouldn't want that, would we? Anyway, you know, I really start getting irritated, folks, because I know the facts. And you should know the facts, as many of us that have spent time and just in your own life, even if nobody presented you the information, don't you question the laws that you live under? Haven't you ever wondered why a plant, and especially hemp, that you can't even say, well, it gets people high, it's not good for them. You can't even say that with this. You can't say it. If we were growing hemp in this nation when Fukushima blew sky high, we could have shipped it all over there and we could have absorbed a major portion. I can't put a percentage because they've lied and not told us how much was released, but I can guarantee you that we probably would have lessened the effects of Fukushima by half, at least, if we were proactive and we were allowed to do what humans should be allowed to do. Let's take a look at the countries that grow hemp: Australia, Austria, Canada, Chile, China, Denmark, Finland, France, Germany, Great Britain, Hungary, India, Italy, the Netherlands, New Zealand, Romania, Russia, Slovenia, Spain, Switzerland, Turkey, Ukraine, Egypt, Korea, Portugal, and Thailand. And then it gives you the list for the United States, the states that are working to legalize hemp. This is an urgent issue, folks, especially here in my state of New Hampshire, where the motto is live free or die. I want to add another little interesting fact that although hemp is illegal to grow in this country, you can't grow this plant that could allow you to produce, I don't know, what is it, 140 different products, I believe, or industries that would be affected if hemp were legal. The facts are, you know, they're in there. I just working out of memory right now. If you want to question me, I'll get you the link. Trust me. Not a problem if you really can't find it yourself, but I think with a little effort you could. But anyway, so you can't grow it here. It's illegal, demonized. But if you go to Obama's website, you can buy products made from hemp that are made in China. Now, how do you feel about that? Your government making things illegal that it's selling to you. You can't do it, but you can buy it from us. That's mafia tactics, folks. That's mafia tactics. And as far as my state of New Hampshire, boasting live free or die, when people are being arrested, fined, thrown in jail for possession of plants, is one of the most ignorant things I've ever heard of. And it's just a blatant lie. We're not free. And we're probably going to die because the things that keep us healthy and prosperous are being withheld from us. There's my rant. I didn't mean to rant. I'm trying not to rant so much. But you know what? This stuff pisses me off. And it absolutely has to end. And it's not going to end until we stop being nice about it and we stop asking. We start demanding. So, you will see that I am one of the admin for the 420 Occupy New Hampshire cannabis legalization page. Going to link you to this as well. And I want to point out something, that on this page, all the time I'm tagging my governor, Maggie Hassan. And what I'm doing, Maggie, in case one of you or your constituents are listening to this, and you damn well better start listening, I'm tagging your name and I'm tweeting your name tied to all this information about marijuana and cannabis and hemp and all the other. You know, it's all the same to me. It's a fucking plant. You've made it illegal. See here, here's one. What I'm doing, Maggie, is creating a trail so that on campaign 2014, when we storm everywhere that you are, and you even try to say, I was unaware of that fact, because we're going to hammer you publicly with facts in front of the media, in front of your constituents, and we're going to make you look like the lying bitch that you are, Maggie Hassan. You got the medical marijuana vote by telling people you were going to finally legalize it for marijuana, and then you beat the shit out of the bill until it's a worthless piece of paper, and most people won't be able to have access to it, and the ones that do will have to pay out their ass just weeks before they die. That's the boiled down version of your medical marijuana bill, Maggie Hassan. You're a lying bitch just like our President Barack Obama, and you both need to be put in prison for violating human rights. When you restrict a human being from possessing a plant that grows on this earth, and then you boast that we are one nation under God, but yet you make God's gifts to man illegal, you are a lying whore. You're an evil, evil woman. And all along your campaign trail, we're going to hear you say, but I wasn't aware of that, and we're going to say, bullshit. Every bit of information that passes through my eyes is tagged to your name on Facebook. Much of it is tweeted. And you can't say you didn't know. You can't say that. Well, I know you don't sit down and put any effort into your Facebook. But somebody very, very close to you does. And by the way, your social networking team is an absolute fucking fail. Absolute fail, because they haven't responded to anything. You only have 3,000 followers on Twitter. You should have every New Hampshire resident that is on Twitter as a follower. And you don't follow back your people. You're a user and a loser and a liar and a whore. And Maggie Hassan, campaign 2014, you damn well better expect us.